So many essential oils have amazing pain relieving properties. And if you want to use essential oils in your bath to make a therapeutic pain relieving bath salt, the one thing you're not supposed to do is take your essential oil and drop it in the tub. That's a no-no, because the essential oils just float on the top layer, they don't absorb in your skin very well, and they can be extremely skin sensitizing. So by mixing them with salt first and then dissolving them in your bath is the safest, one of the safest ways to use your essential oils. Hi, I'm Joanne from Soulful Sister Aromatherapy, and today I'm going to show you how to make your own amazing pain-relieving bath salt using just pure therapeutic essential oils and salts. We're going to follow this recipe right here on this handy-dandy board. We're going to use 2 cups of salt, 1/4 cup of baking soda, and we're going to use 15 drops of essential oil. Okay, so you want to use this blend if you have muscle aches, you work outside, you work with your body, you have fibromyalgia, arthritis, anytime you're standing all day and your feet are swollen and you've got a cold and flu and your body's achy, all of those things can use this recipe. We're gonna start with Epsom salts. And you can see how Epsom salts are not really salt. It is magnesium crystals. I'm spilling this everywhere and that's okay. So these are actually magnesium crystals. And Epsom salts, we know, are amazing at getting rid of muscle tension, muscle pain, swelling, bruising, arthritis pain, makes your skin incredibly soft. Epsom salts are just a wonder for the body. So we're gonna start with that, just 1 cup of Epsom salts. The next thing we're gonna do is add our sea salts. Now, sea salts are incredible because they aid in circulation. They also take away aches and pains, wonderful for arthritis. Main thing that salts do, they detoxify your body. And so our skin is a massive elimination organ. It gets rid of like all the sweat leaves and your body gets rid of impurities through your skin. And so by detoxing the bath, it releases pathogens and microbes that are just in your pores. It gets rid of all those toxins. And then it feeds your skin all these minerals that are naturally occurring in sea salt. Wonderful. So we're gonna start with 1/2 cup of just sea salt, regular sea salt, and we're gonna put 1/2 cup of Himalayan salt. And Himalayan salt is amazing, has all the benefits of sea salt, and has an added energetic component. So if you're feeling kind of like mentally glum, mentally in a rut, helps to clear your energy and let you start fresh, which is what we all really want. So there we go. We have 1 cup of Epsom, 1/2 cup of sea salt, 1/2 cup of Himalayan salt. The last thing we're going to add is 1/4 cup of baking soda. And this is just the luxurious part of it. You can add any amount of this, 2 tablespoons to 1/4 cup. We're gonna add that in because it makes your bath water feel so soft and your skin will feel so soft afterwards. It's just a wonderful addition to any salt. So we're going to just mix that together now. We've got a little bit of a clumpy baking soda going on. It's okay, it'll dissolve in the bathtub. Once that's all mixed together, we're going to add our essential oils. The essential oils we've chosen for today are frankincense, juniper berry, lavender, and rosemary. These all are pain relieving oils. The juniper specifically is an arthritis pain reliever, amazing for aches, pains, and everything like that. So this is the addition for arthritis pain, but all together they're gonna make a beautiful muscle relaxing pain reliever. The blend we're doing has 2 drops of frankincense. Oops. So we're gonna add 2 drops of frankincense. We're going to add 3 drops of juniper berry. You get a few extra drops in, that's okay. We're adding 5 drops of lavender. Rosemary is a wonderful pain relieving, muscle relaxing oil. So we're gonna add our 5 drops of rosemary. There we go. All the essential oils are in. Now all we have to do is stir it really well. And the salt dissolves in the water and it helps disperse the essential oils throughout your bathtub. So your essential oils do not just float on top of the bath water. We're finished. Made a whole bowl of pain relieving bath salts. Now, if you were, say, super achy and you just went for a big run or you've got fibromyalgia, often if you're really sore, we say do 2 cups of salts. Now, this is a great way, if you are using your bath a lot, to make your blend up into a large container, leave it in your bathroom, and you can just scoop out your own salt into the bathtub. It makes it really easy. If you want to make it up for a little gift, spoon it into a little mason jar, which I know everybody has in their drawers. Oh, it's got a pretty little bow, and we made it for you. There isn't anything more touching than making something that, one, relieves pain. You've made it yourself. It's made with love, and that's an awesome gift. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I hope you learned a little bit about mixing essential oils safely for use in your bath water. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the blog post link below. That'll take you to the full recipe. So if you don't want to go back and forth to this video, you can just click the blog post link and follow along there. It'll all be step by step. Thanks. Have a soulful day.